Hello, my friends. Welcome to the Matrix of Whoop, a hardware reference guide for duct brushed microquartz. In this video, I will give you the fundamental knowledge, the key specs you need to know to build, fix, or upgrade any duct brushed microquartz. Many people call many things tiny whoop these days. For me, one of the main defining factors of a whoop is the 26 by 26 millimeter flight controller mounting pattern. Any Inductrix tiny whoop style flight controller can be mounted on any of these frames and hundreds of others that are being made after the thing went viral in 2016. The flight controllers are all the same size, but the motors, propellers, and batteries come in a variety of different sizes and flavors, and if you want to make it work the first time, you need to know exactly what works together. Before I get into the tech details though, I need to make the following disclaimer. I'm trying to make this guide as brand independent as possible and rather mention specifications than brand names. However, there are many manufacturers out there who, let's say, have creative methods of coming up with the numbers on their labels. So if you're using the specifications that I give you in this video and go shopping for parts, you might end up with parts that have the same number on the label but perform vastly different. All right, having this out of the way, let's get started. One of the most important and most obvious properties of all of these parts is their weight. For good flight time, your battery should weigh roughly the same as your four motors. For peak performance, you will need high discharge batteries, and then you can get away with around 50% more motor than battery weight, but you will reduce your flight times to around 2 to 2.5 minutes. 4 to 6 gram batteries work best with 6 by 15 millimeter motors, 31 millimeter props on a 65 millimeter frame. These parts will make a 25 gram quad that flies very similar to the OG Tiny Whoop from 2016. The first and easiest thing you can do to add a little more power is a bigger, more powerful battery with a bigger plug. With 6 gram 205 milliamp batteries, you will get the maximum power out of 6 by 15 millimeter motors. Some frames you can modify to install 6 by 17 millimeter motors, which add a little more power whilst not exceeding a motor diameter of 6 millimeter. To get even more power, we need to increase the motor size to 7 by 16 millimeters. You can use the same propellers on all these motors, but you will need a different frame. Even though the two 65 millimeter frames look very similar, the one on the left has 6 millimeter motor mounts and the one on the right has 7 millimeter motor mounts. You get great performance out of 205 milliamp batteries with the 7 by 16 millimeter motors, but if you want to have more flight time, you can use 255 milliamp batteries. With these parts, you can build a quad that weighs 33 gram, looks almost like the OG Tiny Whoop, but has a decent amount of extra power. When you go the next step up in motor size to 7 by 20 millimeter motors, you will also need to go up in propeller size and therefore in frame size. For a line of sight copter without camera and video transmitter, you can get away with flying 7 by 20 millimeter motors and 255 milliamp batteries. If you want to carry FPV gear, you should install at least 14 to 17,000 kV motors and use 300 to 400 milliamp batteries. With a 12 gram battery, this quad weighs 44 gram. This battery size is not very common, so it's not easy to get the right size batteries to get this setup spot on. Similar to the 65mm frames, the 75mm frames come with two different sized motor mounts, with either 7 or 8x20mm. 8x20mm motors add another 4g to the total, but they also add a significant amount of punch. You get some very good performance out of 400 to 450 milliamp high discharge batteries and some very good flight time of up to 5 minutes from 5 to 600 milliamp batteries. I don't usually talk about the E-Flight batteries, the Blade Inductrix stock batteries, because they are such sad, overpriced, over-labeled underperformers. But the battery from the FPV Plus, the 500mAh 25C, is actually not too bad. With these parts, the quad weighs around 50g, you get around 4 minutes of flight time, and more top speed than with any of the smaller quads. Now it is a bit tight, but you can fit the 600 milliamp MyLiPo into this frame as well. The extra 2g will detract slightly from performance, but you get longer flight times, the longest flight times of all quads on this table. I've got a flight of more than 5 minutes out of this setup. If that's not fast enough for you, you can upsize to 8.5mm motors. And if you do that, you also need to go up in propeller size to 48mm and in frame size. With these parts, the quad weighs around 57g, and with 15,000 kV motors, you get some very impressive performance and flight times from 3 to 4 minutes. And if you use 18,000 kV motors, you get by far the best performance on this table, but also only 2 minutes of flight time. So, that's it for this hardware reference guide. I will conclude with a little summary and recommendation for each quad when you should build which size. I recommend to build with 6mm motors if you want to be as light as possible, if you want to fly indoors only, and if you want to stick to the multi-GP rules of having 6mm maximum motor diameter. If you have no specific reason to stick to 6mm motors, I suggest to build with 7x16mm, because that makes the most versatile combo on this table. Very agile indoor flyer and very nice performance for small outdoor spaces. I recommend to build with 7x20mm motors only when you know exactly what you're doing. If you want to have the longest flight times, use 8x20mm motors and 600 milliamp batteries. And if you're flying primarily outdoors, if you want to handle some more wind, if you want to have the fastest and the toughest whoop in the hood, then I recommend to use 8.5x20mm motors. Now we're getting towards the end of this video. If you have any questions, you might post them in the comments below. And if you want to buy any of the parts, you may click the link in the video description. Now, at the beginning of this video, I showed you this flashback of pictures here. If you want to see any of them a little longer, a little bigger, you can stick around for another minute or two. And if not, then see you later. Wow, you just watched this 14-minute video about microquad geekery all the way to the end. Respect, my friend. Welcome to the club.